Friends, here we go on with chemical thermodynamics. In this part, we will discuss the two fundamental aspects of thermodynamics, heat and work. To begin with, heat. Heat is represented by the letter Q, and it is associated in a process when the system moves from its initial set of conditions to a set of final conditions through a certain path. Like this, heat can be one form of energy change occurring in the process. So, you know, energy is a state function. It is associated with initial and final conditions of the system. And in this energy change, or when the system moves from the initial stage to the final stage, or initial energy condition to the final condition, the energy difference or the change can be achieved through heat, which is a form of energy transfer. Heat is reflected in temperature change, or temperature is a measure of heat. And remember, heat is not identical to energy. It is only a form of energy transfer. Conventionally, we have a misunderstanding there. Heat is equivalent to energy, or it is one form of energy. Remember, heat is not a form of energy, but it is a form of energy transfer. It is a process by which energy is changed. So, it is not an entity, but a process. So, it is a path function. It is associated in path, not a state. There are two consequences with respect to heat. Either heat can be taken into the system, or heat can be released out of the system. For example, when you heat up a vessel in the kitchen or over the stove, heat is given into the system from the surroundings. You can see there is a temperature increase associated. Likewise, when you place the same vessel on lower temperature ice bath, what happens is temperature decreases because heat is released out to the surroundings. And as when the system takes heat into the system, the system energy increases, and now the system can do more work than before. You can see in your kitchen there, after a while, your vessel starts to, or the what is contained, or your system inside start to push the lid up. That is, it is doing certain amount of work by using the heat given from the outside, given from the surroundings. On the other hand, when heat is released out, energy of the system decreases, and system can now do only less amount of work than was before because part of its energy is given out to the surroundings as heat. And two kinds of processes with respect to heat are exothermic process and endothermic process. Exothermic process is one in which energy is released into the surroundings from the system as heat, and endothermic processes involve uptake of energy from the surroundings as heat. Combustion is an exothermic process because during that process, energy is released into the surroundings as heat. That's why we can use burning of wood as a means of producing energy. And dissolution of sugar in water, for example, is an endothermic process. That's why when you drink sugared water, you feel colder in your body, because the dissolution of sugar in your blood is an endothermic process. The process requires heat from the outside. It takes heat from the surroundings, which is your body. So the surroundings, your body feels colder because a part of its heat is given to the system. With that, now move on to the next concept, work. Work is now the fundamental property in thermodynamics. Work is done in a process to achieve motion against an opposing force. Like heat, it is a way of achieving energy change, and work is done against an opposing force. Like in this example, this man is lifting the weight against gravity. The weight is moving upward against the gravity, against the opposing force. And work is a form of energy change like heat. Work is a path function. This is our case, our system, where a gas is placed in a cylindrical vessel like this, which is provided with a freely moving piston on the top, and now I attach a weight on the top of the piston. So what happens is, when the external pressure, the piston applies some amount of pressure on the gas, there is a piston pressure because it is freely falling. So the piston pressure is there downward, and in opposition to that, the gas does some work against the piston pressure. So the weight on the piston can be lifted up. The weight is moving upward against the piston pressure which was applied downward. In another example, like in an electrochemical cell where electricity is produced against the potential difference, this electricity can be used through a motor to lift weight. So the motor is performing work against the potential difference. Okay, now work is a path function. It is associated in a process, we have seen. When the system moves from its set of initial conditions to the final condition along the path, the work is involved as a way to change its energy. This is maybe our initial condition, and after a process called expansion, here the system achieves the final condition. Here the work is done by the system because it is expanding. We will see that work is reflected as a change in pressure or volume of the gas. Here you can see there is a change in volume in this example. As I said, heat is reflected in temperature, work is reflected in pressure and volume. Considering this again, here you can see that the total work, the total expansion work done by the system does not happen in single stretch. This happens in infinitesimally small individual steps like this, and in each step a work dW is associated. Likewise, you have got several steps where dW works are associated, and the total work done in this case is an integral of the individual infinitesimally small works done in the small processes. Here it is important to know two things. The first one, I didn't write delta W because work is a path function. There is, you cannot say a change in work. You can say change in energy or change in enthalpy because these are state functions. When the system undergoes a process, the initial and final conditions may have different energies, for example. But work is a process associated path function, so you cannot have a change in work, but you cannot have a work done in a process. And that work is a function of path, that is why this integral is specifying path. Now, two aspects are there, work done by the system and work done on the system. Considering this, now this work, this expansion work is an example of work done by the system. In another case, in this case for example, this work is done on the system. In the first case, the piston applies a pressure, against it the work is done by the system, and in the second case of compression, the work is done on the system by the piston, by the external agency. So, in the case of work done by the system, energy of the system decreases because a part of its energy is used to do the work. Work is done by the system in its literal meaning. And as the energy of the system decreases, now it can perform only less amount of work than before because part of its energy is used now to do some amount of work. So, it can now do only lower amount of work because it possesses only lower amount of energy. That is why work done in expansion or work done by the system are denoted with a negative sign always. Remember, this is important. And on the other hand, for compression work, when work is done on the system, energy of the system increases. This causes the system to do more work. Now, from this increased energy system, you can obtain more work out. And that is why the work done on the system is denoted with a positive sign. Coming back to this man again who is pulling the weight, He is not pulling the weight in a single stretch. He is pulling the weight in infinitesimally small steps. And in each step of lifting, he is causing a displacement dz to the weight. So, the total work done against the force, the work done in this small step against the opposing force, which is gravity here, as a product of this work force and the displacement. This is the basic definition of work, the product of force and displacement. The total work will be the integral of all these small works done for this small displacement dz. Coming back to our system, there is an external pressure applied by the piston, and against that a work is done. Along individual steps, in each step we have got a displacement of dz, and each step is associated with a work dw, and the total work will be the integral of this individually or infinitesimally small individual work. And dw can be written as a function of force and displacement. And considering the expansion work, the dz, the displacement is positive because it happens upward, and this product will give you a negative work. So we establish once again that expansion work is negative. On the other hand, for compression work, the dz is negative because the piston is moving downward, the displacement of the piston is downward, so it is treated negative. So this product will give you a positive dw, that is why compression is a positive work. Consider your piston is having an area of cross section A, then the total force acting on the gas is the product of pressure and area. Again, this is the basic definition of force, product pressure into area. Replace this area with, the external, the small work here. When you replace this force F with this product, you can write the small work like this. And you can see this A into dz, the area of cross section into the thickness, the dz, the small displacement will give you the volume, the small change in volume. This dv is the small change in volume associated with this displacement dz done in a work of dw. So you can write this product dw as P external into dv with a negative sign. This is an important relation to have in mind. With this, we can deduce some things. If you perform this integration over initial volume to final volume, because during the process the gas is changing its volume from Vi to Vf, this is the work. And we will consider several cases now. The first one, work in free expansion. Free expansion is a case as shown here. This part of the system, the first chamber is having gas filled at very high pressure, and the second chamber is maintained at zero pressure, that is at vacuum. So that the temperature difference between the two chambers are huge. Really huge, not the temperature difference but the pressure difference. Huge pressure difference is maintained across the two chambers, and the two chambers are separated by a valve like this. And what happens if you turn the valve on? The gas from this extremely high pressure region flows to this vacuum region without needing any work to be done, without spending any amount of energy. Therefore, the work in this case is zero because there is a huge pressure difference maintained. Like in a waterfall where huge height difference is maintained, water flows with at its maximum amount of energy downward without needing any external work to be done. That is very similar to that. In this case, the gas maintained at high pressure flows to the vacuum region without needing any work. This is one result that we can deduce. Work in free expansion is zero. Considering the other case, expansion against a constant pressure, consider our system again, and this expansion occurs from initial volume Vi to the final volume Vf. The equation for work is this, and if you do this calculus operation, you can get this result Vf minus Vi, which can be written as delta V, change in volume, Volume is a state function, that is why you have delta V, change in volume. You can write change in volume delta V, not like work or heat. Okay, so work in this case is represented by a product of the constant external pressure and the change in volume happened during the process. Now, before going to the other example, we see the pressure volume graph for this process. Pressure, this is the external pressure, and here are the initial and final volumes. This area under the graph will give you the product external pressure times change in volume, and that is the work. This product is the work. So area under this pressure volume graph will give you the work done in this process. Such a graph is called an indicator diagram. Now we move on to the other example of work in a reversible expansion. Before seeing what is the work in reversible expansion, we will see what is a reversible expansion. To understand it better, we start with a case of thermal equilibrium. A reversible change is a change that can be modified back by varying infinitesimally small parameter, or varying a parameter by infinitesimally small quantity. Like this, you have got the system, you know the system before, this hotter end and this colder end of the metal rod. Heat transfers or flows from the hot end to the cold end, and after a while the system attains equilibrium. Now the system is at thermal equilibrium. Now, suppose you are applying an infinitesimally small amount of heat at one end of the rod. What happens is the system suddenly goes back to its previous state. One end becomes hotter and the other end colder. So the process is reversed. The equilibrium is disturbed and the process is reversed. That is the reversible change. So by applying an infinitesimally small amount of variable, here heat, you can reverse the state of the system. And if you wait for a while, this system again comes back to the thermal equilibrium. Thermal equilibrium will be regained back. So a system at equilibrium is vulnerable, or it is ready to undergo a reversible change. Having this mind, now we will look at mechanical equilibrium, where the external pressure and the internal pressure, or the piston pressure and the pressure of the gas, are maintained equal like this. And suppose now you induce an infinitesimally small change in the external pressure. What happens is system sees that the equilibrium is lost because there is a higher pressure outside. So the system now tries to achieve the equilibrium back. That is why its pressure increases slightly. Its pressure is adjusted to maintain the equilibrium back. So like this, a change in small change in volume happens in the direction opposite to the external pressure. So a reversible expansion is achieved here against this external pressure. If you set the external pressure equal to the internal pressure, and by inducing an infinitesimally small change in the internal pressure, you can see if you induce a small or infinitesimally small change in external pressure, you can see that the system restores the initial condition, and that is why the system pressure also changes by doing a small amount of work. And in reversible expansions, that huge work is not done in a single stretch suddenly, but it is achieved in individual steps by maintaining the condition. Both the pressures are equal in small steps. So in the first step, you begin with the equilibrium. The first step, the external pressure is increased slightly. The system does a small amount of work to balance this. And again, you are supplying in the next step, you are providing additional pressure. The system pressure changes. Like this, you can have the final or the total work done. Coming to this equation, this is the equation of work, and you can replace this external pressure with the system pressure P. Remember, the small p is the system pressure, and only in this case of reversibility you can equate the external pressure with the system pressure. This is an important point to be noted. And if you do this operation, you will get the final or the total work done as a product of the total change in volume against the system pressure for the negative sign, obviously. So that is the case of work in reversible expansion. Now we bring the system, the same system of reversibly expanding gas, to an isothermal condition. That is, the same thing happens. Well, the gas expands from initial volume to final volume, but the condition is that a constant temperature is to be maintained. That is why isothermal processes are constant temperature processes. You know this. In this case, again, the work is the integral of the individual works, and you see, you can write this small work dW is this one, and the external pressure is now equated to the internal pressure small p. And now the internal pressure P can be written like this, considering that the gas inside is an ideal one. For ideal gas equation, PV is nRT. You can deduce the expression for pressure of the gas like this, nRT by V. So you are replacing this pressure with this equation, and by integrating over the initial and final volumes, you can reach this conclusion that W is negative of nRT log VF divided by VI. Now we will see some interpretations of this equation. First, consider the final volume is larger than the initial volume. That is a case of expansion. And in expansion, if you do this, the final product W in this equation will be negative. So once again, we establish that work done in expansion is negative. And in expansion work, energy of the system decreases, and now the system is at isothermal condition, but its energy is decreased in the form of work. Part of its energy is used to do work, and its energy decreases, but the system needs to maintain isothermal condition, so it needs to get energy from the outside. That is why the system absorbs heat from the outside. So for such a system, at constant temperature system, if you see that there is an expansion work going on, you can also see that heat is absorbed into the system. You will not see an increase in temperature of the system because the heat is absorbed in order to compensate the work done. But the surrounding temperature falls down because a part of its heat is given now to the system. Similarly, if we consider compression work where the final volume is larger than the initial volume, you can see that this product ends up with a positive value. That is, again, work done in compression is positive. And in compression work, energy of the system increases. And in order to maintain the constant temperature, the increased amount of energy is dissipated outside, towards the outside, towards the surroundings in the form of heat. So heat is released out to the surroundings in order to maintain the constant temperature or isothermal condition. So you can observe an increase in surroundings temperature. So we see the consequence of work is here is heat. So you can say heat and work are two forms of the same thing, two forms of the energy change. So heat and work are reflecting each other. You can see it from this case. And now we will consider the other thing. Suppose you are having a gas expanding isothermally at a temperature T across the volumes VI to VF. You do the same expansion but at a higher temperature. The same gas is expanding across the volumes VI to VF but at a higher temperature. You can see the work is increasing. So when the temperature increases, work increases. That means if you do the same expansion, the system performs higher amount of work. And if it is on compression, if you do the same compression, you have to do higher amount of work to compress the gas, the same gas, across the same amount of volume. That's it. And now we will see the indicator diagram for this isothermal reversible expansion, where the pressure is plotted against volume. Pressure here is seen from this ideal gas equation. You will see there are at initial volume VA, you have got a initial pressure, and at final volume VF, you have got final pressure. And this is how the graph look like, and the area under this graph will give you the value of work. And there comes another point. See, this rectangular part over here represented the work done in irreversible expansion. We have seen the indicator diagram before. So there is an additional amount of work represented by this triangular region in isothermal reversible expansion than the irreversible expansion. That means reversible work is larger than the irreversible work. And we can also deduce that reversibility is the condition for maximum work. So isothermal reversible expansion is the case where you can obtain maximum work out of the system. So this is very important to remember that reversible work is larger than the reversible one, and reversible isothermal expansion is the case of maximum work. Okay, with that we will now move on to molecular level interpretations of heat and work. We have already seen in the first part that classical thermodynamics has a top-down approach, that it looks the system in a macroscopic scale with macroscopic variables and tries to understand the microscopic level of the system from that set of information. So our system is a gas filled in a chamber like this, and you've got molecules which are in a random thermal motion. The molecular motions are called, they are random and they are called thermal motion because they are part, the motion is the energy motion. This motion energy or this kinetic energy is the part of the internal energy of the system. We will come to this later when we discuss internal energy. So the molecules in your system are in a random thermal motion. What happens when heat is taken into the system? Heat is given from the surroundings to the system. The molecules are obtaining energy or heat by absorbing heat, or by this heat process the molecules obtain energy, and this stimulates thermal motion. The thermal motion become vigorous. Molecules in the system moves more vigorously than before. On the other hand, the same system, when you have got heat liberated out to the surroundings, the system is giving heat out to the surroundings, what happens is the thermal motion of the molecules outside the surroundings is stimulated. The molecules in the surroundings move more vigorously than before because the surroundings molecules obtain heat from the system. So we can conclude that heat is a property that makes use of a random motion of molecules. Because here we are addressing thermal motion of molecules. The heat has a consequence on the thermal motion of molecules. So heat makes use of a random motion of molecules. But coming to work, consider work done by the system like in an expansion. In this, what happens? What is moving? The weight is moving. The weight shown here is moving in a given direction. It moves upward like this. The weight is moving. The molecules in the weight is moving upward in a given direction in an organized manner. So work, on the other hand, work on the system, the weight is moving downward in an organized manner. So you can see that in work, the molecules of the weight in this example are moving in a given direction, that is in an organized manner. So work makes use of organized motion. So this is the most important thing to understand, that heat addresses, or heat has a consequence on the random thermal motion of molecules, whereas work has a consequence on the organized motion of molecules. So, in this part of the lecture series, we have seen what is heat and work. We have seen the expression of work. We have seen that heat and work, both they are path functions, they are processes, and they are means of achieving energy change of a system when the system moves from initial state to the final state. And we have seen expressions of work in different cases, like in free expansion, expansion against constant pressure, irreversible change, reversible expansion, exclusively isothermal reversible expansion, which is the case of maximum work, etc. And we had a look on the molecular level interpretation of heat and work, by which we concluded that heat addresses the random thermal motion and work addresses the organized molecular motion. And with there we end this part of the series, and the next big thing that we will address in the next lecture is internal energy, heat capacity and the first law of thermodynamics. So hope to see you soon with that. Thank you.